International Space Station!
ISS. Which has got to stand for, it's so spectacular!
And so big!
And coming up fast!
Bus, do your stuff!
Less fast! Less fast! Still too fast!
Prepare for docking! I just have to line up the things!
And, oh, a little to the left, a little to the left.
Miss Frizzle!
Okay, oh, nope, steady as she goes. Here we go. Nope, a little to the left. Nope.
And we're collapsing!
And I'm totally comfortable with our speed now. Are we in orbit yet, Miss Frizzle?
Keisha, my friend, I think we are.
Awesome!
More stars than you could ever count!
Just tell me when it's over!
We're in space! We're in space!
We're in space!
That's right, Keisha. We are now in low orbit around the Earth, which means...
Turn the engines back on! Why should stop the engines?
Now that we're up to the right speed and height, we don't need them anymore. There's barely any atmosphere to slow us down, so we can just coast in orbit. I've seen a lot of space movies.
Yeah, well, I'm not taking any chances. Assume crash landing position!
No.
Which one is my favorite?
What are you doing?
No engines! That means any second now we could fall back down to our doom!
Not quite, Arnold. Being in orbit is a perfect balance, like this. You need to circle the Earth at just the right speed.
Whoa! Just fast enough to resist Earth's gravity. If we go too slow, the Earth's gravity will pull us down. But if we sped up too much,
we could fly up into space.
Something's not right.
Wait! When the original Frizzsats got smashed, they weren't just in one orbit. I zoomed all over the place, remember? How could we forget?
Which means we need to find the right orbits for all our satellites.
How do we do that?
Well, what better way to find the right home for a satellite than to become one?
Wow! Look at you!
But Miss Frizzle, how will we know when we're in the right orbit?
Trust me, Arnold. When you feel it, you'll know.
That's what they said about poison ivy, too.
So this is low Earth orbit. We're like 200 miles off.
Or 340 kilometers. Look, you're getting a signal.
It's pictures of the Earth. That's why my cameras are pointed down.
Better send that data to the scientists down below.
I think I am. Whoa, look at you.
I'm an astronomy satellite taking pictures of the universe. My cameras point out into space. I can see for thousands of light years.
Here we are. Maybe on Earth orbit. About 20,000 kilometers above the Earth. Anybody getting anything?
Hold on. I think so. Hey, I'm a GPS Frizzsat for figuring out maps and directions on Earth.
Me too.
Me three. Looks like we're working together as navigation for sets in medium Earth orbit. Anybody need directions?
Not me. Got plenty already.
Now entering geosynchronous orbit.
Hey, I love this song. I must be getting signals from a radio station. Excuse me while I spacecraft.
And last but not least...
Ralphie, Chief Maintenance Officer.
What's a Chief Maintenance Officer?
The janitor. I'm psyched, because I get to do stuff like this.
Doing?
That capsule is filled with, ta-da, dirty laundry.
Cool.
Look at that.
Awesome.
Whoa, what just happened?
Since there aren't any washing machines on the ISS, dirty laundry goes into a capsule that we drop into Earth's atmosphere, where it burns it up as it falls. Result.
Is that a monogrammed hand towel?
Yep. Never leave Earth without one. Okay. But now that we're actually in space, I will be super serious. Trust me.
Good. And the first step in being serious is communication. It's important to let everyone know what you're doing at all times.
All right. I'm scratching my armpit now because it's super itchy.
Interesting. So there's no such thing as over-communicating in space?
Nope. See? Even the labels here are written in both English and Russian for the crews that speak those languages.
Huh.
English-speaking astronauts learn a little Russian, and Russian cosmonauts learn a little English.
That's right, and they end up speaking a mixture of the two called Runglish.
Meshdunarodny yazyk.
Cooperation and love! I hope.
Very convincing simulation. I even see sunspots! Did you know they can erupt into solar flares with the power of 1 billion tons of explosives?
Fascinating. And note, the VR system even simulates the rising temperature as we get closer. Nifty, huh?
Maybe a little too nifty for safety. What if a delicate student overheats?
The bus also features an excellent air conditioning system.
Never can be too safe, you know.
Uh-oh, what did I hear?
Dashboard update. Moves the controls around again. I'm afraid that you've accidentally activated the ejection seat.
Oh no.
Guys, look!
Arnold? Is that you?
You made it!
That's not Arnold at all. That's just the mag bag. Where's Arnold?
Means one thing.
Let's go get Arnold!